So why did God test Abraham? Did God really want Isaac to die? Well, of course not. God doesn't want anyone to die because that's not love. We discussed at length in our videos on Genesis chapter 1 that God is love. So if God didn't want Isaac to die, then why did God put Abraham through all this mess? And that's a great question. It all has to do with trust and loyalty. In the very first verse of chapter 22, we read, God tested Abraham. These words give us a decisive key to understanding the story. God does not want the death of Isaac. Rather, he is putting the boy's father to the test. There's an ancient Jewish book called the Talmud that says, God tests everyone, one with wealth, another with poverty. A rich man is tested in whether he extends an arm of support to those who need it, a poor man in whether he bears all his sufferings without discontent and with obedience. God made some pretty huge and important promises to Abraham, and God wanted to make sure that Abraham was worthy of these promises. Last time God made promises, things didn't end so well. And I'm referring to the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve. This is a theme that will continue to come up throughout the scriptures. God continues to reach out to us, his greatest creation, in hopes that we will reach back and love him in return. When our first parents ate from the forbidden tree, God didn't say, "Oh well, that was a fun experiment." God didn't throw away his whole created universe and start again. God is love. Love doesn't destroy. Rather, love continues to restore and fix what is being loved. God reaches out again and again to humanity. And through Abraham, he reached out again in hopes that humanity would reform and turn back to its creator. And this is why Abraham is important and why this great test is remembered. God wanted to see how far Abraham's love would stretch. And luckily for all of us, Abraham passed the test.